a star to be in my show. No, sir. That's just a rumor that Joe Rock and Roll McCoy started.
Baby, come as you are with just your heart, and I'll take you in. You're rejected and hurt. To me, you're worth what you have within. Now I don't need no superstar, 'cause I'll accept you.
Frank Fiore, and this is Bob Wheatley. Today's game is going to be versus the Westchester All-Stars and the Under-19 Junior National USA team. We're here at Ossining High School today, and the game is going to be brought to you by Continental Cablevision, Community Channel 6, and the Hudson Valley Chapter of the La Crosse Foundation. Now to my partner, Bob Wheatley.
There are seven players from Westchester County that will be participating on the Under-19 World Team. They are from Yorktown High School, Roy Colsey, Rocco DeAndrea, Jason Foley, and Dave Moore. We also have Lakeland grads, Ricky Beardsley, Christian Johns, and Anthony DiMarzo. Coaching the Hudson Valley team is current New York State champ Yorktown High coach Jim Turnbull and New York State semifinalist coach Frank Vitola from Lakeland High School. After these messages, we'll continue with the game. Thank you very much.
The best of what is made in America is what you see, hear, and feel when you tour America. For a free guide to traveling in America, call Travel for Tomorrow, 1-800-755-TOUR.
Made in America.
Right now, I'd like to introduce you to the Hudson Valley All-Star team.
Andy Seal, defense, Adelphi University.
Eric Strube, defense, University of Maryland.
Bill Adele, attack, University of Massachusetts.
Andrew Greenberg, midfield, University of Pennsylvania.
Anthony DeAndrea, midfield, Yorktown High School.
Usman Greed, midfielder from Yorktown High School, play for Guilford College.
Matt Dwan, defense, Loyola College.
Mike Cross, goalie, Cornell University.
Kevin O'Connor, midfield, University of Massachusetts.
Joe Mahoney, defenseman, Ithaca College.
Mike McGrain, College Herkimer in Virginia.
Joe Borges, midfield, Yorktown High School, Rutgers University.
John Kniff, attack, John Jay High School, Army.
Mike Hoynes, midfield, Yorktown, Army.
Paul Cannon, midi, retired.
Adam Silva, defenseman, West Point.
I have to talk to you.
Don Connolly, attack, Towson State.
Rick Nacido, attack, Hartwick College.
Amelia DeLisa, attack, Corning Community College.
Gary Skelski, midi, Herkimer.
Name's Alfredo Miola, just finished Lakeland High School, going to Elmira College. Played defensive midi.
That's the Hudson Valley All-Star team.
Okay, and I'd like to introduce to you the USA Under-19 lacrosse team.
My name is Rick Beardsley, but my friends call me the Cooter, Syracuse University, hometown of Yorktown.
Yeah. Kevin Jacobs, attack, wrestling the art.
Hey, my name is Greg Tranar. Went to Conestoga High School, go to the University of Virginia now.
Step up, fellas.
Name's Tony Nugent from Baltimore, Maryland. Went to Calvert Hall High School, and I go to the University of Virginia.
Rocco DeAndrea, goalie, Rutgers University.
Dave Marr, attack, Yorktown.
Hi, my name's Chris Johns. Went to Lakeland High School. I play attack. I go to Loyola College.
Anthony DiMarzo, attack, Putnam Valley, Lakeland High School.
Eugene Curran, midfield, Garden City, Long Island.
Dan Sheehan, midfield, Western City.
Todd Higgins, defenseman from Port Washington, New York, 10 Princeton University.
Hi, my name is David Segnar, midfielder from West Tennessee.
Pat Marvin, midfielder, Garden City, and I go to Harvard College.
Thank you.
Rich Gargiulo, Farmingdale High School, midfield.
Hi, my name is Joe Wilson from Columbia, Maryland. I currently attend Virginia University.
My name is Mike Iorio. I play defense, and I'm from University of Notre Dame.
My name is Roy Colsey. I'm from Yorktown Heights, New York. I'm a midfielder, and I play for Syracuse University.
It's not that hard.
Dave Severin, midfielder from Floral Park, New York.
My name is Jay Stauffer. I play goalie at Brown University.
Mark Allen, defense, Duke University.
David Evans, attack, Brown University.
Jason Foley, defense, Yorktown High School, Loyola College.
Hi, I'm Tim McGeaney. I play goal, and I'm from Loyola College.
Chad Smith, defense, Bolden High School.
Ryan Wade, midfield, University of North Carolina.
Coach, thank you very much.
How you doing? I'm Mike Buzza. I'm midfield, and I go to Penn State University.
Okay, thank you, fellas, and stay tuned for all the lacrosse action.
That's my dad. And that's Mom. Dad's got an idea. A way to get rid of all the grody garbage that's polluting the world. He's invented a big rocket ship to shoot all the garbage into outer space. Mom's not sure, but Dad says his invention will save the world.
There's an easier way to save the world. Recycle for your free recycling action guide, right? Recycle, Environmental Defense Fund, 257 Park Avenue South, New York, New York.
We're ready to start the game at Austin High School. The Hudson Valley All-Star team in green, the USA 19 and under junior nationals in blue. Again, this game is being brought to you by Community Channel 6 Continental Cablevision and the Hudson Valley chapter of the Lacrosse Association. Teams are lining up and the game will start momentarily. Players shake hands and we're ready to go.
And we're ready for the opening face-off of today's match.
Referees for today's game are Al Blau, Steve Murray, John Bazzulli, and John Hill. Here we go. It's a beautiful day for a lacrosse game.
And USA gains possession on the opening faceoff, only to have it taken away by the Hudson Valley team. That's
shot by
nine.
John Kniff, saved by Rocco D'Andrea. Rocco comes up, passes the ball off. USA sets up its offense.
That's Eugene Kern with the ball from Garden City, now attending Duke University in North Carolina. Hudson Valley gains possession and attempts to clear the ball. John Connolly from Massachusetts momentarily loses it. The ball's in play.
Ball goes back to Hudson Valley goalie Michael Cross.
And they start the clear. A little sloppy to start, don't you think, Bob?
Absolutely, but it's going to take a little while, plus the fact that neither one of these teams have had much time to practice. Basically, that's the purpose of this game is to give the USA team some game time, some field time against quality players.
Yeah, it must be tough for them coming from all over the country to have to come together and try to get some practice time in.
Absolutely, especially when they start only a few weeks from today is when the World Games start down at Hofstra in Long Island.
That'll be a World Junior National Tournament between, I believe, England, Canada, Australia, Japan. And this year, the Sioux Nation will be attending.
Nope.
With
Iroquois Nation. Iroquois Nationals.
Excuse me.
Joey Borges brings it in. Turns it back. Hudson Valley All-Stars playing good 6-on-6 attack here. Shots in. Possession stays with the Hudson Valley All-Stars.
Hudson Valley doing a little change on the fly. John Kniff working the back of the cage.
Joey Borges has the ball, driving towards the cage, looking for the shot. There it is.
Saved
by Rocco.
Rocco
D'Andrea. Roy Colsey with the ball, taken away. USA team, Ricky Beardsley with the ball.
Ooh, feet inside and a score.
That was number 37, Anthony DiMarzo from Lakeland.
An assist here from Christian Jones, also from Lakeland. Little change on the fly, Bob. We got a little unsettled goal there happening.
And a nice score by Lakeland connection of Christian Jones to Anthony DiMarzo. Christian is attending Loyola University, and Anthony is going to Delaware, where he was the rookie of the year this year in the league down in Delaware. Good job by them. Face off, control by Hudson Valley.
Good pursuit and a good check by the USA team to check it away. But the Hudson Valley again gets the ground ball in the possession. Okay, we just have a loose ball violation, which just is a possession foul, which means the Hudson Valley team will regain possession of the ball. John Kniff starting in the back of the cage again, checked away.
Ooh, fine check, ball goes out of bounds and goes over to the USA team.
And Niffer's gonna have to protect that stick a little more. The US defense is playing very aggressively.
Shot on goal, nice save by Mike Cross. USA gets possession again. Dave Marr behind the goal. Now out to Christian Johns, tough defense, looks like we're... Another possession foul, ball goes back to Christian Johns, USA team.
Andy Seal again on the defense. We had another possession foul there, a loose ball hold, so the ball stays with the USA team. Dump inside, looking for a feed. Eric Strobe on the loose ball. Still. Now the USA. John Kniff with a great ground ball at midfield. USA is taking it behind.
Switching on the fly.
Hudson Valley's taking it behind.
Here we go, 6-on-6. Shot coming here. Shot and score.
Beautiful roll move and a great shot, Bob.
Paul Cannon, Lakeland High School and Syracuse University scored that goal. Nice job, Paul.
It's all tied up here, 1-1. Ready for another face-off. Hudson Valley with another possession. Great ball movement.
Anthony DeAndrea coming down, looking for the shot on his brother, Rocco. Ball taken away by USA, coming down the field.
Number 24, Dave Seymour, brings it across midfield, dishes it off.
Dave Marr with the ball across the field now. One of the few players on the team that graduated from high school this year. Dave, an All-American from Yorktown High. Going to attend John Hopkins University in the fall. Beautiful, beautiful behind-the-back shot.
Oh, we have the goal waved off for a crease violation. The goalie is protected by a 9-yard-wide crease there, Bob. An offensive team can't step inside it when they're attacking the cage.
Crease violation took away an absolutely beautiful goal by Dave Moore. Joey Borges with the ball now, coming down the field, setting up to John Kniff behind the cage, back out front.
That's number 6, Bill Adele from Massachusetts working the ball. Dishes off to John Kniff.
Nice defense, aggressive defense.
Nice feed.
Shot and score.
Feed.
Number 6, Bill Adele.
John Kniff to Bill Adele.
Very nice goal.
That makes it 2-1. Hudson Valley ahead of the USA Junior National Team.
We have some interesting matchups here today. You have Rocco DeAndrea in the goal for the USA World Team, and you have his brother, Anthony, number 12 for the Hudson Valley All-Stars. Possession on the face-off, controlled by the USA team. Quickly down to Kristen Johns.
Andy Still on the defense.
Ball. Therefore, Dave Moore, being closest to the ball when it went out, retains possession for the USA team.
Jerry Key defending now. Now Andy Steele.
Nice check.
Beautiful check by Andy Steele. But the USA retains possession.
Nice double by the Hudson Valley team. Ball going into the crease.
Andy Steele with the ground ball. He's bringing it up the field. Kind of a one-handed cradle there, Andy has today.
Ball in.
Feed.
No. Just missed connection.
That wasn't a shot. That was a pass. Goes out of bounds. The USA retained possession, and we're going to have some changing on the fly here. Rocco and the U.S. team attempt to clear the
ball.
Got
Ricky Beardsley open by the midfield stripe. Rocco still bringing the ball up. Swings it over. Back to Rocco.
And the USA clears the ball.
Michael Hoynes playing defense right now for the Hudson Valley All-Star team.
feed inside, deflect it away.
Roy Colsey with the ball, over. Roy, a freshman at Syracuse University with the ball now. Third-team All-American his freshman year, shoots, just misses. Very quick whistles today, very quick whistles. As soon as the ball's back in possession, the whistle blows and the game goes on. Dave Morris swinging in, trying an inside roll. Doesn't get it, looks like he may be in the crease, but no, Michael Cross picks up the ball. Nice defense by the Hudson Valley All-Stars.
One of the reasons for the lack of horns today is that they're playing international rules, the rules that the team's gonna have to play under in the tournament in Hofstra, which doesn't have any whistles and breaks. All the changing and all the penalty time is gonna be served on the fly. A little wild pass there, and U.S. team's clearing the ball.
Roy Colsey, long pass to Roy. There he is. Ball down on the ground, picked up by Hudson Valley All-Stars, and they're off. Ooh. Roy's got the ball again.
Mike Hoynes with a good check, and the Hudson Valley gets the ground ball and the clear.
Looks like the referees are letting this go a little bit today, right, Frank?
Oh, sure are.
But
let them play.
Because when they get down to the games down at Hofstra, they are going to be aggressive games, and so the referees should let them play the game.
We have a lot of great players out there. The best thing they could do is just let them play, Bob.
Interestingly, the referees for this game are going to be the same shot. Are going to be the same referees that will be down at Hofstra during the World Games, and the reason that they're here is so that the players get a chance to get used to them.
And the refs, the players, Bob.
Absolutely. Mike Hoynes over, cutting off the fast break.
Eugene Kern with the ball.
Nice check.
Shot,
very
check
nice
wide.
Check.
USA is going to settle it down here, a little settled offense. They're going to change up some players, get some fresh men on the field.
Mike Hoynes playing defense right now. Nice move. Dishes off. Here comes Dave Marr. Just missed on the opposite side. Shot and score.
Way to fight through the check there by
Anthony DiMarzo. Second goal by Anthony. Very nice.
He came to play today, Bob. And we're all tied, 2-2.
I didn't see the assist, but I think it was number 15, Kevin Jacobs from Vestal, and going to Hofstra now.
Just a beautiful individual effort to fight through that check and get that shot off, Bob.
Outstanding. Very tight, very tight. Face off. Eric Stroop going for possession. Still. Beautiful. Oh, nice save by Rocco D'Andrea. Off the loose ball.
Hudson Valley fighting for the ground ball there, getting a good shot off right in the hole.
Oh, beautiful defensive play. Very, very nice. Ball on the ground. Oh, we have an unsettled situation. And ball out of bounds. USA retains possession of the ball.
USA is working the ball, a little 6-on-6 offense. And
ball goes into the crease.
Beautiful check.
Nice defense. USA retains possession. Ball going into the crease, looking for the shot. Doesn't get it, nice defense again. Still looking for the shot. Ball over to Jacobs. Number two, Tony Nunchin from Virginia Calvert Hall High School. Flag is down, our first flag of the day, and a wicked check by Adam Silva.
I think we're actually going to have two infractions here, Bob.
Well, I know we have a late check because I just saw Al Blau signal it, and we have a hold as well. You're right, Frank.
The hold was the original call, and the late check came in when Andy Silva stepped up, and well, you really got to step out on that guy hard there, Bob.
Absolutely.
But I think with the follow-through there and the head, we're going to protect the players out there today. So Hudson Valley's going to be down two players.
Hudson Valley's got the box. Four players on the field defending six. Roy Colsey with the ball. Dave Moore. Ball is pushed into the crease. Looks like in and out. In and out of the crease. The ball, possession of the ball is going to go back to the USA team. Unfortunate error. Here we go. We're back in action.
The first penalty is up now. So the Hudson Valley team is going to be down another player
Wicked
for
shot.
30 more seconds. As the late check was a minute, and the original penalty, a hold, was 30 seconds.
So now we're 5-on-6. Dave Moore with the ball. Roy Colsey setting up on this side. Oh, nice face dodge, but he lost the ball at the end of it. Dave Moore is getting it back. 5 seconds left in the penalty. Silva ready to come in the game. Ball to Colsey. Nice move inside, but ball taken away.
And the penalty's
Mike Cross
up,
out of the
we're
goal.
All even. We're all even at 6-on-6. Beautiful job by the Hudson Valley team. Down two men and to kill both those penalties. This is probably one of the few times that the USA team actually had a chance to work their man up offense. What do you think, Bob?
Absolutely.
It looked a little slow, a little...
Well, just like the Hudson Valley All-Stars, though, they haven't had a real big opportunity to practice either. So that's, again, that's the purpose of this game, is to get them some playing time.
Yeah. And those man-up plays are very set, very precise. You really want to get a lot of practice time in on those.
Oh, right in on the goal. Silva with the check. Nice ground ball. Took the attacking player by surprise here with a behind-the-back pass by a defenseman.
And the Hudson Valley's changing their players,
Donnie
getting
Connolly.
Their offensive unit on.
Donnie Connolly of Towson State fame. Actually, it's quite remarkable. Donnie's in a game. He pulled a hamstring not too long ago. Good effort by Donnie.
I don't think you're going to keep him off the field today, Bob.
Flag is down.
And the Hudson Valley team brings it outside the box, so the play is called dead.
We have an unsportsmanlike conduct call as well against number 47, Ricky Beardsley.
Yeah, Ricky Beardsley first got the infraction for interference, and then it picked up an extra minute on unsportsmanlike conduct. I tell you, Bob, these refs aren't going to take any flack from the players.
No. Ricky graduated from Lakeland High School last year and became an honorable mention All-American defenseman at Syracuse this year. So, ball's right into the crease. Oh, turns. Kevin O'Connor with the shot. You are Hudson Valley trying to retain possession. Joey Borges has it coming in.
Nice.
Right on. Oh,
beautiful
by Donnie Connolly.
Beautiful.
Very, very nice. Nice ground ball by Joey Borges. Very nice shot and score by Donnie Connolly.
So the Hudson Valley team takes advantage of their man-up opportunity and goes ahead 3-2.
Oh, okay.
Hear that?
Well, when someone scores number three, Donnie Connolly.
Oh, okay.
Possession by Joey Borges.
Beautiful outlet pass by Mike Cross up the field, and Hudson Valley's running.
Number 16, Kevin O'Connor. And the penalty has expired, and the teams are all even. Oh, unfortunately, a high pass. Looks like it's going to go. No, it dies on the ground. Hudson Valley, Joey Borges retains possession. Anthony D'Andrea trying to come in on his brother Rocco. Passes the ball into the crease. Oh, just missed. Just missed connection on that pass.
And Hudson Valley gets the ground ball again. That's where they're winning this game here, Bob, on the ground balls.
Absolutely. Hudson Valley looking very, very sharp for only having one practice. What a pass and shot. Oh!
So one advantage the Hudson Valley team, Bob, they're going to have here is they're a little bit older. Got some cagey veterans out there. Well, the U.S. team, under 19, obviously a very young team.
Yep, Donnie Connolly, number three, trying to dish the ball off. Couldn't do it. Nice ground ball. Number nine, Joey Borges for Hudson Valley, picks the ball up and starts bringing it into the offensive half of the field. Here he comes.
Checked away by the U.S.
Well, Ricky Beardsley with the ball.
Beautiful ground ball.
Ricky again with the check. Donnie Connolly, number three for the Hudson Valley team, gets a one-minute slashing call, so the USA World Team will now go back on the man up. 5-on-4. Roy Colsey will take the ball midfield, bring it in, and USA will set up.
The USA is going to have a one-minute advantage here, Bob. See if they can make the best of it. They let a beautiful opportunity, being two men up, go by a few minutes ago. Let's see if they can capitalize this time.
Oh, off the post, number 43, Ryan Wade.
The USA had much better movement with the ball that time than Bob.
Absolutely.
Ryan Wade with the
ball.
Ryan
Wade, Roy Colsey taking a shot. Nice save by Mike Cross. Mike Cross, currently the goaltender, or one of the goaltenders for the Terrytowners club team in the Cortland Summer League.
And Andy Seal tries to clear the ball. I don't know if we're going to have an infraction
there.
Here. Oh, with possession. So that'll be a 30-second infraction on number 10, Dave Evans, the attacker from Loyola. And the Hudson Valley penalty expires, so they're going to have a 30-second man-up opportunity here. But stolen away by the U.S. Let's see if they can clear.
Nice ground ball, nice ground ball. Ball out of bounds. Only a few seconds left for the Hudson Valley team to set up a man-up opportunity here, but 5 seconds. Ball in. Penalty is over. Unfortunately, because of that
fast break opportunity here for the U.S., see if they're pushing the ball.
Oh,
inside.
Beautiful play.
Oh,
just missed the goal.
Wide.
Number 15, I think that was, yes, Kevin Jacobs again.
They really rushed the shot there. I think if he knew how much time he had, he would have turned around and really finished that play. But the Hudson Valley goalie closest to the ball when that shot went out, so Hudson Valley has possession here again, Bob.
Another beautiful pass by Mike Cross. Over to Michael Hoynes, Mike bringing it into the offensive sector. Over to his fellow teammate at Army, John Kniff. Kniff with the ball, shot, score. Score by John Kniff. Little Army connection going out there between Hoynes and Kniff. John Kniff, number four for the Hudson Valley team.
And it's 4-2 Hudson Valley. It's a beautiful day here at Ossining High School. And I think in the second half, I think the heat's going to become a factor. It's about 82. A little bit muggy. And I think these young legs for the U.S. are going to come through in the second half, Bob. What do you think?
Absolutely. It definitely is very hot. Joey Borges with the ball, though. Over to Kniff. A little fast break here. Break is off. Break is over. But the Hudson Valley team retains possession, gets the players they want on the field. See the timekeeper on, so the clock is on. The first quarter has got about a minute left to go. Oh, ball was tried to be forced into the crease. Did not hook up. Rocco sends the ball out. Adam Silva with the ball.
Down to Don Connolly. To number four, John Kniff, to Connolly. Number six behind the net.
No, that's Adele.
Ball.
Number six is Adele. Oh. That's all right, Frank.
I'm sorry, number six, Bill Adele with the ball again. Five seconds left in the half.
Bill Adele trying to find somebody. Oh, he still has it shot. Nice save by Rocco D'Antrea to end the first quarter of play.
And that's the end of the first quarter. We'll be back with more lacrosse action right after these messages.
In an emergency, you don't have time to learn what to do and where to go. So be prepared before an emergency happens. Learn first aid and CPR. Put stickers on all your phones with the numbers of your local police, firefighters, paramedics, and poison information center. Find out where your nearest hospital emergency room is and know how to get there. For more information about preparing for emergencies, write the Will Rogers Institute, White Plains, New York.
All right, welcome back to second quarter lacrosse action here at Ossining High School versus the Hudson Valley cross team All-Stars and the USA Under-19 national team. We're just ready to begin the second quarter. The score is 4-2 Hudson Valley. Hudson Valley on the possession and the clear. Might have a fast break opportunity.
Looks like he's looking for the shot. Doesn't get it.
USC with the ground ball, bringing it up the field.
Beautiful. Oh, into Kevin Jacobs, number 15. Steve Kavovit in the goal now for the Hudson Valley All-Stars. He's been a two-year All-American out of Yorktown High, just graduated from Maryland. Outstanding goalie.
Oh, beautiful check by the USA.
What do we have? Little interference.
Loose ball. They're going to give the ball back to the USA team. Hey, if you drop your stick, Bob, you're not allowed to touch another player.
That's right. That's where the interference call came in. Whistle blows quickly. USA bring ball down into the offensive half of the field. Kevin Jacobs again with the ball over to Yorktown's Dave Moore. Ball into the crease. Shot.
USA regains possession.
Oh, sneak into the crease area. Oh, almost connected. Defensive stick got up and deflected the ball. Nice play by Kavovit.
Out of the goal, making a nice man ball play. Took his player off the ball.
USA has possession. Comes Andy Seal down. Gets himself stuck there. Nice, nice ground ball by John Kniff.
Number four, John Kniff. Beautiful ground ball.
John's been all over the place today.
Yeah, he's really playing, really playing. Now Don Connolly, number three, back onto the field for the USA.
Number 11, Gary Sigelski, picks up the ground ball. Gets it over to Hector Hoynes.
Number 15.
Over to Kniff, back behind the cage, to Adele.
Bill Adele drives
the cage. Looking for the shot.
Nice feed to Hector Hoynes.
Message to Hector.
Hector
shot. Save. Rocco D'Andrea is still in the goal for the USA team. Nice clearing pass up the field. Have a fast break opportunity for the USA team. Oh, ball right in on goal. Nice
beautiful
save by Kavovit. Unbelievable save by Steve Kavovit. And
we're going to have a penalty, I believe, on the U.S.
Beautiful play. Michael Hoynes taking the ball right up to the midfield line. Great job by Michael. There's the whistle. Mike Hoynes taking advantage of international team rules. Nice save by Rocco D'Andrea.
Yeah, Bill Adele tried to sneak that through his legs, but Rocco got right down on it. Beautiful play by the goaltender there and a one-on-one opportunity.
Great play by Mike Hoynes, taking advantage of the international rules, picked the ball up off the ground and took off downfield before the whistle blew. Perfectly legal play in international rules. A little 6-on-6 action here. Mike Hoynes out to play defense on number 9. Roy Colsey.
But the international
double team on Roy. They're waiting to get, looks like there it is.
And
nice.
The penalty's up. They're all even.
Jerry Kernan. Very nice job carrying the ball up the field for the Hudson Valley All-Star team.
Jerry Kernan, he's not on.
Team's getting evened up on the field now.
Hudson Valley player driving the cage, feet inside, was through.
Fill it down.
Bat it out. Roy Colsey with the ball
coming up
on
the field.
Move.
This is what Roy does best. Clear the ball by himself. Deceptively fast. Outstanding stick. Shot. Dave Marr with the ball. Trying an inside roll. Puts the ball into the crease. Checked away the Hudson Valley All-Stars. And Andy Seal should have this ground ball. Over to Cavett. Cavo seeing up, looking upfield. What a pass by Cavo.
Beautiful outlet pass by Andy Cavo. Sorry, Steve Cavo.
Oh, shot. Rocket shot. Number 14, Hudson Valley All-Stars.
Danny.
No. Usman Green.
Usman Green.
From Yorktown High School. Outstanding blast.
Beautiful shot. High, off stick side, Bob.
Goal set up by a beautiful clearing pass by Steve Cavo.
And Hudson Valley taking a 3-goal lead, 5-2.
Unbelievable. I don't think that the USA team thought that this game was going to be this competitive. Still early, though. A lot of time left. But what a showing by the Hudson Valley All-Stars thus far. Face off. Looks like it's going to be controlled by the USA.
That's number 16, Greg Trainer. Bringing the ball across for the U.S.
Ryan Wade with that blast, number 43, on the field again. Kevin Jacobs looking for the shot. Nice move. Drops the ball. Cavo has it. Steven out of the cage. Passes the ball off to number 12, Anthony D'Andrea. Anthony caught himself in traffic there, but retains possession of the ball. Nice job, Anthony. Very nice job to Bill Adele. Might have stepped on the line. USA takes possession of the ball. USA gets all six players on the field, sets up their 6-on-6 attack. Number 2, Troy Nugent. Over to 15, Kevin Jacobs. Nice pickup off the ground.
And Randy Wade with the ball.
Ryan at Virginia at the present time. Looking for the shot. Coming around. Here it comes. Glass, Cavo there. USA retains possession. Greg Trainer with the ball. Looks like they're going for the sweep. Ball into the crease area. Behind the back. Cavo gets a foot on it. But he's out of the cage now. Trying to get back. Doesn't get back in time. Loose ball situation. Unfortunately, had no choice but to go after the ball. And when the USA picked up the ball, he was out of position to make the save.
5-3, Hudson Valley, USA.
Still a fine effort by Cavo on the first shot. Vince Papora just came into the stadium, joined by his two young children, enjoying the day, enjoying the game. Face off.
That last goal for the USA, Bob, is all a result of them hustling for the ground ball.
Absolutely.
They're going to have to get that tilted in their favor if they want to get back on top here.
Looks like we have a change of goalie. Change of goalie, yes, for the USA team. We'll get his number and name in a second. Number 19, Jay Salfort.
Plays at Brown University, Bob.
Brown University.
Jay does. Check up.
Who? Right on Cavill. Nothing he could do on that. One on one.
That's number 16, Greg Trainer, all alone in front of the net, puts away the goal.
Very little a goalie can do in this game when you're one-on-one with an attackman. So skillful these days.
So Greg's goal closes the gap to just one for the USA. Hudson Valley leads 5-4.
Rocco D'Andrea out of the goal now for the USA team, but played an outstanding quarter and a half. Face off, loose balls, loose, picked up nicely by Skelski, but dropped.
Number 10, Paul Cannon with the ball.
Paul scored the first goal of the game, takes a shot, ball coming back upfield. USA team. Oh, better look out, Adam Silva's looking for another one of those big hits. Danny Sheehan with the ball, looking for the shot, brings it back over. Oh, nice play by
Andy Seale again. Steal.
Andy again playing an outstanding game.
Fast coming break down opportunity.
He's going in for the shot. Oh, ball was blocked. Loose ball.
Picked up by the USA.
Is that Ricky Beardsley over there? Yeah, it was Ricky Beardsley. Brought the ball up nicely. Horn on the play. Al Blau, referee, just called a personal foul on the USA team for not having their players back far enough.
On the bench, Bob, the official in the box is going to have to see both ways. Now he's going to have a procedure call on the green. That's just a possession foul. And he's going to set the tone for these players. This is what the tournament's going to be like down in Hofstra. And a timeout for the Hudson Valley. We'll be right back after a short break.
We pledged our allegiance to it when we were young. We studied its importance when we were in our teens. We sing its praises at every sporting event. We display it when we celebrate, lower it when we mourn, and honor our heroes with it when they've fallen. It stands for what we are and what we believe in. How we treat it says a lot about us.
Okay, welcome back to lacrosse action. The USA has possession of the ball, and they're going to have to clear it.
Two unusual calls, but as Frank just said, Al Blau setting the tone, getting the USA team ready for the international rules. Oh, long clearing clear. Pass. That's about beautiful job.
It was about an 80-yard pass, Bob, upfield to find that man.
Roy Colsey with the ball now. Got a 1-4-1 with Roy with the ball. Ball down on the ground, but Roy, oh, no. Nice ground ball. Number 21, Almiola. Oof.
Little high check. Out to Kevin O'Connor.
Kevin O'Connor.
Controlling the ball for the U.S., driving the cage. The shot.
Nice
and
shot
a beautiful
by Kevin.
Save.
Nice save.
By Jay. Jay Stalford with a beautiful save on that. And USA gains possession and brings the ball across the field. Oh, pass wide. And it's and staying in.
Dies. Ball dies on the sideline.
Beautiful grass here at Ossining, Bob. A beautiful field for a lacrosse game.
Actually, it's excellent. Excellent day, excellent field. Oh, ball down the field. Oh, behind the back pass, but we have a penalty on the play.
Down, a penalty coming up. Number 44, Blue, is going to get 1 minute for a slash. I think it's for the excessive hit on that play there, Bob. He'll serve 1 minute, and the Hudson Valley team is going to have a man-up opportunity.
Hudson Valley setting up. Getting the ball around. Oh, ball sent into the crease, but a nice hit put on by USA.
And not too much room in that crease there today, Bob.
No. Man-up play is especially tough for the Hudson Valley team, and then they've only had 1 day to practice. Trying to get the ball around, back behind the cage, ball down on the ground.
fighting for the ground ball.
Picked up by
Hudson Valley gains possession. Back behind to number six, Bill Adell. And the feed.
Looking for the shot.
Top shot.
Oh.
Wide.
Just wide. Here we go. We all even now? No, we're still in a man-up situation. About 5 seconds left. Oh, right off USA player's helmet.
Yeah, Kevin O'Connor with a shot right off the USA player's helmet there. And defenseman steals the ball.
And the guy just came out of the penalty box, comes in, and now has a fast break for USA. Usman Green getting down very quickly.
Beautiful
nice
goal.
Fast break situation. That play was started by the USA player coming out of the penalty box, his penalty up, and getting a nice...
Number 15, Kevin Jacobs, putting Kevin the fast break away. With the feed from number 12, Christian Johns. Perfectly executed fast break there, Bob. Had to make all the passes.
Absolutely. I'm looking up number 19, Jay Stalford, the goalie for the USA team. Perfect clearing pass up to the defenseman coming out of the box. Outstanding play by the USA team. Knots the score up at 5 apiece.
The Hudson Valley with possession. Eric Strobel on the ground ball.
Beautiful ground ball by Eric. Over to Hector Hoynes.
A little confusion in the USA substitution area there, Bob.
We got the flag down. There you go.
Flag's down. Hudson Valley's going to have to keep it in the box. Ball's down and the play stops and we'll have the infraction. And he'll serve 1 minute for a slash there.
33, Jason Foley from Yorktown unfortunately gets that slashing call. Jason had an outstanding season down at Loyola this past year.
That slash, Bob, was for you.
Ball over to Michael Hoynes. Frank.
He hit the player in the head. Now, they're really a liberal, let you play out there, but anytime you hit a player in a
head
or a vital area, they try and keep
That's
it tight.
Right.
You're going to have to serve the minute.
Ball coming down. Fast break opportunity for USA. Nice check. Adam Silva with the ball. Here we come the other way. Beautiful clearing pass. Up and connect.
Hudson Valley bringing it in.
Has an opportunity. Has an opportunity here. Nope. Ball forced into the crease.
A loose ball push. It'll just be a possession foul, and the Hudson Valley will regain possession outside the box. Bill Adell with the ball.
5 seconds left to go in Foley's penalty. There goes Jason Foley back on the field.
And we're all even. The feed, wide. And it's out of bounds off a pass, so the USA is going to have possession.
USA getting out of their offensive set a little bit here, forcing the crease. What
Number
a save
40.
By Cavett right off of his foot.
Number
Beautiful
43,
play.
Ryan Wade, trying to unload that cannon he
Another
got.
Cannon by Wade. This is interesting. Cavett with the ball coming up the field. Player behind him.
We have an open net now. The goalie's out. Oh, a beautiful
nice
check.
Nice check. Cavett still after him. Cavett gets the ball away.
And Bill Adell reaching the stick to the other side of the midfield to pick that up. Now, he's an attackman, so he can't come over, but there's nothing against him sticking his stick over and grabbing that ball, Bob. Beautiful play by Adell.
Absolutely, and Cabo keeping things exciting for the Hudson Valley All-Stars. Little shake and bake behind the goal. There it is. Oh,
beautiful
play.
Feed.
Joey Borges, number 9 for the Hudson Valley All-Stars from number 5. I'm sorry, let us get our...
Emilio.
Emilio DeLeza, from Mayapack and Corning Community College, made that feed from behind the cage.
Yeah, it's all there. Just lacrosse waiting for him.
Hudson Valley again takes a one-goal lead, and it's 6-5 now. Ready for the next phase. So a beautiful play by Joe Borges, who just graduated from Rutgers University. Very nice play.
They fight for the ground ball, and Hudson Valley regains possession. Now we'll attempt to clear.
Behind the back by a defenseman. Over to Joe Borges, who just scored that last goal.
Borges again with
Joey on his horse. Cutting in, looks like another shot. Oh, beautiful save.
Great save by Jay
Stalwart.
Stalwart there.
USA looking for the midfielder with the short stick to play defense. Another save by Kavovit. Clearing pass to Osmond Green. Very, very nice. Ball checked just at the last second. Ball went high. USA takes possession. There's that quick whistle again, Frank, that gives that fast break opportunity.
Yeah, these players are going to have to hustle on and off the field. All the changes are done in the substitution box on the fly, Bob.
Kevin Jacobs and Dave Marr. Danny Sheehan back now to Marr behind the cage. Marr having an outstanding game. Jacobs just taking the quick shot. Cavill had the side of the cage clear and lets Jacobs know.
USA again with possession, Bob. They're going to try and take the man one-on-one from up top here. Looks for the feed. Good check by the Hudson Valley.
And here they are off to the races. Setting up the fast break with John Kniff on the point with the ball. Beautiful play. Outstanding. Outstanding fast break. Let's see if we get some numbers here. Number three.
Don Connolly on the assist.
Donnie Connolly on the assist. And number eight, Rick Nacido.
Rick Nacido finishing the beautiful fast break play there, Bob. It all started with number 19 for the Hudson Valley team, Joe Mahoney, with a beautiful takeaway and a beautiful fast break. Okay, so Hudson Valley's up by two again, 7-5.
Joey Mahoney playing for the Ithaca Bombers right now. Timeout USA.
We'll be back after these messages. Okay.
Six months ago, this man's heart suddenly gave out. He had no pulse. He could no longer breathe. He got help from someone who learned CPR at the Red Cross. They got help from the United Way. Thank God, the United Way got help from you. The United Way. It brings out the best in all of us.
Again, this game is coming to you from Austin High School, being put on by Community Channel 6, Continental Cable Vision, and being sponsored by the Hudson Valley Association, or the Hudson Valley Chapter of the La Crosse Foundation. If you're interested, please contact Bob Wheatley, P.O. Box 23, Tarrytown, New York, 10591, or call me at my office at 631-3434. Face-off about to begin. And we're on. Roy Colsey fighting for the ball. Mike Coins comes up with it.
If you're getting a little confused, though, Mike Coyne's got two names, Mike and Hector. Hector's nickname. There's not two of them out there. There's just the one.
Oh, just misconnecting with Mike Coyne's. USA's going to have the ball. Here we come. Jason Foley coming down this side looking for the fast break pass.
And he shoots and scores.
Score.
To pull the U.S. team to within one.
Chad Smith with the score. Was Jason Foley running downfield alongside him. Chad did not dish the ball off, took the shot himself and scored. Great game we have here, back and forth, a lot of action.
Great day, great players, great game, Bob.
What a day for a lacrosse game. Mike Hoynes going underneath, trying to get the ball, comes up with it, but loses it. Great play by Hoynes.
Hudson Valley with possession.
Ball out of bounds. USA will take over.
I was off Hudson Valley stick, so possession will go to the U.S. Upfield, midfield to Roy Colsey.
not normal for Roy. He's been pretty quiet today. I think he's going to look for his opportunity right here in this shift. What do you think, Bob?
I'd love to see it. Roy's an outstanding player.
Number 20, Eugene Kern with the ball.
What a
strip by Eric Strobe. And I think he got a little extra in there.
I don't think they're calling a legal check. I just think that one of the USA players is down. They're calling for a trainer. Check looked legal. Just caught the USA player wrong. They want to make sure that everything's okay before play continues. Smart move.
He's up. He looks all right. Bob, I think he wants to continue, but I think they might make him come out anyway.
Eric, a graduate of University of Maryland, is coming off the field. Maybe he does have a penalty.
No, the whistle was called, and Hudson Valley has possession.
Okay.
So they're going to get the long sticks on. They're going to take the long sticks off and put their offensive unit on.
Michael?
Up right after. And play continues with the U.S. team riding the Hudson Valley team.
Oh, unfortunately, bad pass. Kavovic's out of the goal. There he is, back in the goal.
I think the quick whistles are catching everybody by surprise there, Bob.
Even me.
That's for sure.
Ball over into the corner to Jacobs. Number 16 for U.S. is Greg Trainer. Greg looking for the sweep. Coming back, looking for the shot. Still looking.
Double by Silva.
Now he's behind the cage, looking out front. Ball into the crease to Nugent. Oh, what a pickup.
The ball goes green after a great ground ball by Greg Trainer. And the Hudson Valley's on the clear.
Kavovic pass connects with number 11,
Pat
Gary Sikelski.
Sorry, Gary.
USA trying to get all six of their players on the field and set up their six-on-six attack.
Here comes number 43, Ryan Wade, onto the field.
We've seen his blast before today.
He's got the ball up top. He also has a short stick from the Hudson Valley team guarding him. I think we might see him try a little one-on-one play here, Bob.
There he goes, absolutely right, and there's the blast. Oh,
and
right into the upper
beautiful
corner.
Shot by Ryan Wade.
Not much Cavill could do with that one. Wade has got a blast. As we said before, Wade now a member of the Virginia Cavaliers. Oh, boy, Ryan Wade's going to come after me. Ryan is a member of the University of North Carolina. My apologies to Ryan. We don't want to mix up those ACC teams. Timeout on the field. Taken by the Hudson Valley All-Stars.
As we're all tied here at 7-7 at Ossining High School.
USA taking a couple more seconds to figure out what they're going to do with the remainder of this second quarter.
They better hustle onto the field. The official's blowing the whistle. They're going to have 25 seconds to get ready here. As they've been calling it today, there's been no slacking around here today, Bob, by the officials. Very tight called game. In the substitution box, on the field, everywhere.
Last goal by Wade, not at the score at 7. Beautiful face-off by Borges. Starts a fast break. Looking for the shot, got the hold, flag down. Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Here we go, Hudson Valley All-Star, looking for the shot right away. 30-second penalty on
Don
the hold.
Don Connolly with the ball, feeds inside.
Beautiful
hold
to Joe Borges.
Ground ball.
Donnie Connolly picks
Don
the ball
Connolly
up.
With the ball. Beautiful check by the USA player. Ball's down. Jay Stalford out on it. Picks it up. And USA has possession as they start to clear. They are a man down.
Let's see if the ball's going to die again.
And it does. Beautiful.
Jacobs, nice
Jacobs
pickup.
Beautiful ground ball, but he's down. And Andy Seal picks it up.
Beautiful by Andy Seal.
Off to Kevin O'Connor.
Joey Borg just looking for the ball. Number 10, Dave Evans with the ball. Dave looking for his shot, gets the ball over. Nice save by Kavovich to end the first half. Score at the end of the first half is 7-7. We'll be right back with more lacrosse after this public service announcement. Stay with us. We got a great, great second half coming for you.
Michael, what happened in school today?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Thanks, honey. Come on. Something must have happened.
Nothing.
Sweetie, finish up the beans.
Teresa, what'd you do today?
Hi, I'm back. This is Bob Wheatley. We're back at halftime here at Austin High School. All knotted up, 7-7. I have with me the coach of the Hudson Valley All-Stars, Yorktown High School coach Jim Turnbull. Jim, how's it going so far?
Well, I'm surprised we're doing as well as we have. Our team has never played together, but they're doing a real good job.
Anything that you're going to specialize in the second half? You're going to try and open the game up or play a little more 6-on-6?
Well, we just hope we can run with them. I think they're probably in a little better shape than we are, but... Just try to keep moving the ball.
That's Jim Turnbull, Yorktown High School coach. Best of luck to him. Thank you very much, Jim.
Okay, welcome back to Austin High School for second half action of the USA Under-19 World Team versus the Westchester All-Stars. Ryan Wade with the ball, number 43, brings it down, dumps it off.
Number 12, Christian Johns again. Passes over to Nugent.
Nugent with the shot and wide. Mike Cross is back in the cage for the All-Stars. Hudson Valley All-Stars. Number one, Mike Cross. A Cornell University alumni. Alum.
Greg Trainer looking for the shot. He's got it. He's coming around.
A good double there by Borg. Just came to help out.
Nice save by Mike Cross.
USA on the ground ball, and they come up with it.
Dave Maher.
Dave Maher with the ball in midfield.
Picks up the ball. Dave Trainer again looking for his shot, passes the ball in. Oh, right off the face mask of Mike Cross. Guzman Green has the ball. Nice play. Going on Wade, has him. Nice play. Nice play coming from the back.
Stick was checked last minute there, Bob. He's going to dish it off. He had an open man low. The ball just checked out of his stick at the last moment. USA dishes it off.
Christian Johns takes a shot.
Wide. And Mike Cross, closest to the ball, gets possession for the Hudson Valley team. Good hustle by Mike Cross there to get possession for the Valley team.
Ball goes across to Jerry Kiernan. Jerry working on Christian Johns. Around and the ball is cleared.
He clears the ball to
John Kniff.
John Jay High School and West Point grad. Number 6, Bill Adele with the ball behind the cage. Trying to work his man. Now to John Kniff. He'll take a shot with the ball. Oh,
like
man open on
shot.
The side. Shot.
Nice
Ooh.
Save.
Jay Stalford still in goal for the USA team.
Beautiful play by Jay.
Held the pipe there, didn't give him any room.
Open.
Good defense by Andy Seal. What a step up there.
Number
10
for USA
door.
Is Dave Evans. Had a couple nice shots in the last couple minutes. Back behind it, Kristen Johns. Chris passes through the crease. The ball is on the ground. Roy Colsey after it now. Roy comes up with it. Roy Colsey from the Tim Schur Vacuum Cleaner School of Ground Balls. Back over to Chris. Chris behind to Dave Moore.
USA with good ball movement here. And the flag's down with penalty upcoming.
Tough call by Al Blau. Sure, he's got him for the slash.
That's number 10. Paul Cannon's going to serve a minute for a slash there. And USA is going to have a man up opportunity and a chance to go ahead for the first time in this game. Or second time in this game. They led 1-0 and not since.
Ooh, ball almost got past Ryan Wade. Ball over to Colsey. Over to Dave Moore now, looking for the sneak. Oh, rocket blast. Mike Cross right on top of it. Cross is playing an outstanding game. Both goalies here. Matter of fact, all four goalies for both teams are playing great games.
Andy Seal.
Andy Seal.
Great hustle up the sidelines to clear that ball.
Oh, we have a slashing ball. Keep the ball in the box. Perfect. Perfect. John Knipp, and he scores. Beautiful play. Plus, it's probably going to be a personal foul slash, so the Hudson Valley team will still get a man-up opportunity out of this. Coach Jim Turnbull, realizing that the Hudson Valley team needs the faceoff, put Joey Borges on the field.
And the Hudson Valley penalty has expired, so just a penalty left to the USA team, so they will have a man-up opportunity here.
Very
Bob, granted they could get possession of the ball on the faceoff here, there'll still be a faceoff.
Borges, ball behind him. Runs through the ball. Ball
yes,
is picked up. Beautiful
Hudson Valley
job.
Gets possession of the ball. They'll have a man-up opportunity. Ball over to number 6, Bill Adell.
Number 18, Matty Dwan did a fantastic job on that faceoff, getting the ball down.
Ball number 9,
Mike Horns
Borges.
Comes in. Whoa, ball was tipped up in the air.
Feed to Borges, tipped wide. Borges on the ground ball.
Let's see if he can retain
Fight
possession.
Fight forward at midfield.
Borges still does not have it. What do we have here? Looks like Blue may have stepped. Blue did. Blue
Loose
stepped on.
Ball offside, so the possession will go to the Hudson Valley team. There's still a few
there
seconds left in the man
there goes
up.
Kniff over to Hector Hoynes. Oh, did not connect on the pass.
Off a stick, and it's going to stay in.
5 Jay seconds
Stalford
left
on
the
ball.
Penalty.
And the penalty is released. And they're all even out on the field. Hudson Valley with possession. The penalty has expired. And they're all even. John Kniff with the ball. Moves it up to Borges. Borges at the top of the box. Drives the cage. Beautiful check by the USA player.
That was number 25, Todd Higgins.
And the flag is down.
Number 25, Higgins attending Princeton. The NCAA Division I national champion this year.
Number 9, Borges picking up a slash on that play there, Bob. That was a little tight.
I didn't see that.
That was a one-hander.
So we have the USA team with a man-up opportunity. Absolutely right, Frank. We have a man up here for the Team USA. Wade over to Colsey. Colsey to Moore. Moore looking for the shot. He's got...
Feed to Jacobs.
Jacobs
shot
just
wide.
Missed the goal. Here it comes. Moore behind the cage.
To Colsey. Shot.
Whoa.
Score. Another blast by
Ryan Wade.
Ryan Wade again. He's the real go-to man there and the man up there, Bob. They tried that play down low twice, didn't happen. Right back up to Wade in the goal.
Nothing.
And we're all
Mike
knotted up here at 8-8. Early third quarter, all tied up 8-8.
Ryan Wade, the Tar Heel, not the Cavalier. Fantastic blast.
Some school down south, right, Bob?
One of those schools.
Thank you.
Faceoff won by Team USA. Dave Moore with the ball. Danny Sheehan with the ball. Passes it back. Oh.
Hey, just threw that one out of bounds there. Bob just got away from him.
Hudson
Valley's going to clear.
Oh, and again, uncharacteristic by Mike Cross as well. Whistle is blown.
USA is changing up their players. Dave Servant on with the ball now in midfield. He has a short stick. He might try and take a little one-on-one opportunity here.
Being covered right now by Kevin O'Connor.
He dishes it off to Dave Signor. He's going to try on defense. Usman Green, and the flag is down.
I'll tell you right now, Frank, this game is being called much differently in the second half than it was in the first half. Maybe by design, though. You want to get some man-off opportunities.
Well, also, the players are feeling a little fatigued. It is a hot day there, and they get a little sloppy out there, Bob, and that's the thing we're going to have some of the penalties come from. Anyhow, Usman Green will serve a minute for slashing.
Team USA has too many players on the field.
And they'll lose possession there, Bob. They'll still be a man up if they can get the ball back.
Mike Cross gets the ball up quickly. Jerry Kiernan. Jerry looking for an open man. Gets it over to Kevin O'Connor. Kevin trying.
Tried to split the midfielders. You can't do it.
With possession. Great play by Kevin O'Connor, forcing that penalty.
And Number 10 for the USA team, Dave Evans, going to have to serve 30 seconds for that infraction. Right now, they're all even until the penalty on the Hudson Valley player expires. So we're playing 5-on-5.
Nice save. Nice save.
Nice save by Jay, again in the goal.
Shot by Anthony DeAndrea. Anthony trying to get the ball back.
And the Hudson Valley team is up.
Joe Wilson with the ball now. Now he's passed it off. Beautiful clearing pass, and here comes the ball.
Penalty has expired, and we're all even here again.
Play getting a little bit sloppy.
Bill Adell with the ball.
Hudson Valley getting back into their 6-on-6 offense.
Bill Adell working, a dish to Don Connolly.
Ground ball picked up by the USA. Here's Ricky Beardsley with the ball, coming down. Fantastic ball control. Ricky forces a penalty. Slashing penalty. USA with another man-up opportunity.
Another man-up opportunity for the USA team, Bob. And I think in international rules, it's good to note that Al Blau, the man, the official was doing the substitution area in the first half, is now on the field and calling the bulk of these penalties. The senior official on the field.
There you go. Beautiful play on Dave Mark.
A loose ball hold on the Hudson Valley team. The possession will go to the USA team. Hudson Valley got to hustle back in there. You have two players standing around.
Fantastic play. Dave Moore took advantage of those international rules again and just took off with the ball before the whistle blew. Ryan Wade.
Roy Colsey.
Roy Colsey with the ball. Nice pass.
Oh, and a beautiful goal just over my cross. He's very frustrated in the goal today. It's tough to play defense down a man, Bob.
Absolutely. Goal by number 16, Greg Trainer. Penalty is over. Roy Colsey on the assist there. After that goal, USA has taken the lead 9-8. Game going back and forth at this point.
I think the Hudson Valley players, the All-Stars here, Bob, are going to want to have to slow down the game here, play a little more 6-on-6.
Absolutely, it's a hot day. Nice face-off. Smart move getting it back to goalie Cross. Over to Andy Seal, who's had an outstanding game today.
Yes, he has. There's the clear to Andrew Greenberg. Down to Bill Liddell. Behind to
John Kniff.
Seed to Khan. Beautiful move, spin move, and a goal.
Beautiful, beautiful.
I think we're
going
to have a penalty also about.
Go in the personal foul slash.
I hear you.
Let's see who Coach Turnbull puts on the field for this face-off.
Number 47, yep. Rick Beardsley is going to have to serve a minute for that slash, and we're going to have a man-up opportunity if they can gain possession.
True to form, Coach Turnbull puts Borges back on the field for this face-off. Borges trying to get the ball.
And Hudson Valley gains possession.
Let's see who this is. Very, very nice play by number 25, Todd Higgins, Team USA. Okay, USA, or Hudson Valley has possession of the ball, trying to set up their man-up offense. Mike Hoynes into the game now, 30 seconds left to go in the penalty. Key now is patience. Mike Hoynes got the ball, got the shot off, but was just a little bit off balance.
A little high, Bob. Couldn't release that quick enough. Ran out of room there with the crease.
The 5 seconds.
Just on the ground ball.
5 seconds go in the penalty.
Now Bill Liddell comes up with the ground ball.
But the penalty is over.
As the penalty expires.
Ricky Beardsley coming back onto the field.
We're all even. Mike
Hoynes looking for a shot. He's got it. Oh, just wide. Just wide by Hoynes.
Mike Hoynes again with the ball. The feed. Loose ball.
Loose ball in front of the crease.
USA up with it. And the attempt to clear.
An outlet pass. Very nice outlet pass. Looking for the fast break. Oh, what a save. What a stuff save.
Beautiful outlet pass to Borges. Here comes the Hudson Valley team. To John Kniff. To Mike Hoynes. Oh, beautiful steal by the USA player. Ball's down, though.
Joey Borges looking for it.
Joey Borges
comes
on it again. Still with the ground ball. Back to Usman Green.
Borges takes the ball off the post. Behind the back to Kniff, but his stick was checked. May have a little interference call. Oh, we have an in-the-crease call against John Kniff.
USA takes possession of the ball.
Goalie play, a mirror image of the first half. All four goalies, outstanding play. Number 21, Al Miola,
playing
some tough defense.
Procedure call on the USA team, so possession will go to the Hudson Valley squad.
Usman Green again with the ball. Rick Nacido over to John Kniff. Kniff driving the goal. He's got it.
And he draws the foul.
Probably a hold. That's it. Holding call. John Kniff playing outstanding.
That was number 34, Chad Smith on the hole. He's going to have to serve 30 seconds.
This is where it's difficult for the Hudson Valley team. With only having one practice, it's real hard to set up a man-up type of offense. Rick Beardsley throws the ball away behind the back, but the USA team comes up with it nonetheless.
It's Jacobs with the ball behind the cage, and he feeds the long stick with a shot. Number 32, Joe Wilson, staying on that field, getting himself open, taking a good shot. And the USA still has possession. Greg Traynor with the ball.
USA getting all their players on the field.
Over to Ryan Wade.
Here's Ryan. Ryan's got his move, looking for a
drives
shot.
Drives the cage.
Comes around.
Hey, Traynor with a shot, and a beautiful save by Mike Cross, an even better outlet pass. Nuts and Valley's on the run. Mike Cross playing a beautiful game down there.
Absolutely. Oh, we have a timeout because a child wandered onto the field. Good call by the official. We don't want anybody hurt here.
Very enthusiastic young lacrosse player there, Bob. That's all.
Absolutely.
Fun to get in the action.
I think that was George Searing's nephew over there. I met him at halftime. Enthusiastic lacrosse fan.
Can't wait to play.
There goes Kevin O'Connor. We're going to have an interference call, though. Goes Team USA. Ball up, looking. Jerry Kiernan looking for the hit. Adam Silva. Ball's picked up again by Kiernan.
Rolls away, trying to find somebody open. Looks for Mike Coins, intercepted.
Absolutely.
By number 37, Anthony Delmarzo. Well, has two goals and looking for his third here today. Mike Cross with the ball. They're going to start the clear. Ball's out to Andy Seal. Upfield.
Up to Kevin O'Connor. Kevin slices through, loses the ball, but going back after it. Loose ball situation. There we go.
Beautiful ground ball by the Hudson Valley team there. Good ball move.
Nice possession. Very nice possession.
Jason Foley defending. Mike Coins with the ball. Craig Traynor defending. A short stick. I think Mike's going to try and take him here for looking for an opportunity. Feeds.
Beautiful. Nice save.
The shot bounces high. Feed from John Kniff inside. And a crease violation. The ball will go to the USA team. Beautiful ball movement. Great opportunity for the Hudson Valley team, Bob. As we're all tied here, 9-9. Someone's trying to break the ice. Greg Traynor with the ball. Eric Strube defending for the Hudson Valley squad.
Traynor's had some great one-on-one moves, so Eric's going to have to watch him.
Mike Cross comes up with another good save.
Jerry Kiernan, who's having
Hudson Valley's clearing the ball again.
Coming down the field. It's a tribute to both these teams that we haven't had any offside penalties today. With all the players coming on and off.
There you go, Bobby. Jinxed him.
The officials meeting here. Don't quite know what it's about.
Meeting of the minds, Bob.
John Kniff coming off the field. Having a great third quarter.
I think we have an equipment timeout for a Hudson Valley player. We want to make sure all his protective gear is on correctly.
Paul Cannon.
And Hudson Valley has possession.
Billy Adele's back in the game. Ball's floated over, right behind him. Gary Sigalski. Nice roll around Roy Colsey. Roy's after him. Nice defensive play by Roy. Jerry redirects back to his goalie Cross. Cross with a long outlet.
Beautiful pass. Don Connolly with the ball.
You know, we have a shoe on the field. I don't know whose it is, but somebody's shoe.
Running so fast today, Bobby. Coming out of the shoes.
Looks like it's Billy Adele.
He's going to have to go for that Puma disc system next.
But we're not...
Short equipment timeout here. We'll be continuing play momentarily.
Looks like 2:05 left in the quarter. Again, the game being brought to you by the Hudson Valley Chapter of the Lacrosse Association. Looks like about 200 people at the game today. Beautiful day, great game. Glad you could join us. Number 6, Billy Adele, nice feed. Just missed.
Yes, beautiful feed by Adele.
It was over to Andrew Greenberg. Donnie Connolly, always tough on the ball.
Donnie's got the ball now. Up top to Greenberg.
Hudson Valley controlling the play right now. Doing a great job 6-on-6.
This is going to be to their advantage. To slow the play down here, Bob, play a little 6-on-6 and keep that USA defense out there as long as they can.
Absolutely. On the sideline, I see Steve Cavett warming up, getting ready to come in the goal for the Hudson Valley team in the fourth quarter. Ball back behind the cage. Oh, misconnected there. Ball will not go out of bounds. Wilson, I believe, on top of the ball. Gets it over to Mark Allen.
Mark Allen dishes it off to Jacobs.
Kevin Jacobs has the ball now. Roy Colsey in the game.
And he's going to slow the game down here, get his offensive team on. Smart play by Jacobs there, Bob. He knew his teams were playing a lot of defense. He pulled the ball out, let's get their offensive unit on and go to work.
Absolutely. Behind the goal of Chris and Johns. Chris taking a look, being covered by Andy Seal.
Feet inside, nice. So DeMarzo checked away.
Adam Silva, nice play.
And Eric Strobe with a beautiful ground ball. Passes it to his goalie and back out to Andy Silva.
Ten seconds left in the third quarter. Andy Seal just running the clock out.
And at the end of the third quarter, it's the USA 9, the Hudson Valley All-Stars 9.
Fantastic. We'll be right back with more lacrosse after this public service announcement.
Schools throughout the region are now teaching students with the support of Continental Cablevision's Cable in the Classroom project. Cable in the Classroom provides free educational programming that is also completely commercial-free.
The programs we watch in school, they're like made for the classroom, so they're a learning experience. They're good to watch. The business world is making attempts to contribute to the educational process.
Continental Cablevision. We put everything on the line for you.
Let's see who Team USA number one, Joey Kermser from Wilton High School in Connecticut is their new goalie. So Team USA using a third goalie today. Roy Colsey facing off against Joe Borges.
And Hudson Valley gains possession. Oh, only to have it stolen by the USA team. They look upfield.
Stolen back. Number 18 for Team USA, Matty Dwan. Very nice play by Matt.
Bill Adele with the ball.
Sun
up
just came
Usman
out
Green.
First time. This is going to be a hot quarter, Frank.
You say that again, Bob. Usman Green with the ball. Trying to break
looking
that 9-9 deadlock.
Ball on the ground.
A loose ball push. The ball's going to stay with the Hudson Valley team. Bill Adele with it. Behind it, John Kniff. Kniff
for
Usman
feed. Green,
Usman Green. He puts away the feed. Beautiful
score.
Goal. Beautiful feed. So the Hudson Valley team goes up 10-9 by Usman Green's goal from John Kniff.
See where Usman's going to school. Guilford down in North Carolina. Excellent, excellent play by Usman. Joey Borges, little helmet repair.
Hudson Valley team with a 10-9 goal here. 10-9 lead early in the fourth quarter.
Sun came out. It's probably about 85, 90 degrees. It's a hot one. See who has got the most gas left in their legs. Face off, Roy Colsey against Joe Borges again. Joe Borges comes up with it, but Colsey right behind him. Nice play by Borges. Just missed Kniff.
Kniff on the ground ball.
Getting pushed right next to the sideline.
Stays in bounds. Beautiful play by Kniff.
Tiptoeing down the sideline. John Kniff passes the ball over.
Donnie Conley
looking for the shot. Save.
By Joe Kersmer. Joe Kersmer, outstanding athletic play to keep this game tied. Keep this game one goal. Kevin O'Connor with the ball, passes it off to Borges. Borges driving the cage.
Back to
it off.
Oh, beautiful play. Oh, there you go. Number 12, Anthony DeAndrea. Anthony's been looking for that shot all day. Finally got it to click for him. Very, very nice goal.
Beautiful roll move. Beautiful roll move. Beautiful shot, Bob. And the Hudson Valley team up by two again. 12-10. 11-9, I'm sorry. I'm ahead of myself, Bob.
No problem, Frank. It's hot for everybody out here.
You can say that again.
11-9, I'll tell you, this is, you're going to see what the USA team's made up here. The Hudson Valley All-Stars, coached by Frank Vitola and Jim Turnbull, are playing just an excellent game.
Yes, they are carrying the play now, Bob. I thought the USA team would have the advantage in the fourth quarter.
Paul Cannon with a nice face-off.
And the USA with a beautiful ground ball. Flag is down.
Okay, here we go. Our first opportunity for the USA team to get one of those goals back. They have a man-up opportunity.
Yes, Paul Cannon again.
Paul Cannon.
Flash. We'll have to serve a minute. Number 10, Paul Cannon.
Just before that splash, though, I noticed one of the USA team players throwing Paul Cannon's stick away. So maybe that's what started the splash action. Here we go. Roy Colsey with the ball. Looking for a shot. Has the shot. Steve Cavett making the high save. Steve back behind the goal. Steve's looking for his defenseman to come back down and set up the clear.
Well, Steve is just going to sit back there and make them come to him.
Absolutely.
Because,
let him waste some time.
Kill that penalty time.
Andy Steele again up the sideline. Andy's had a great game. Back to him.
Off to Mike Coyne.
Over to Cabo.
Valley's very smart. Killing the penalty on their end of the field with the ball.
Cabo taking the ball back behind the cage. Wasting some more time. 5 seconds left to go on the penalty. Great job by the Hudson Valley team to get rid of this penalty. Cannon's back on the field. Teams are even. Here comes Hector Hoynes.
Mike with the ball, dumps it off, passes over to Paul Cannon, passes low, ground ball picking up by the USA team.
Nice play, here they come. Number 10, Dave Evans with the ball right now. Dave had some great moves in the third quarter.
USA's changing his midfield, gonna get his short sticks on now. They should have some good offensive opportunities because Hudson Valley has all their offensive middies on. Only three long defensive shafts on that field for the Hudson Valley team.
It's important 6-on-6.
Jacobs with the ball behind the cage.
Sequence here for the Hudson Valley team.
Andy Steele
defensively
defending.
And offensively for the USA team. Dave Morick in with the ball. Dave looking for a shot. Getting doubled. Dave held on to the ball.
Okay.
Like Dave
procedure
was
call against the USA team for withholding the ball from play. Big Al Blau spotted a little thumb action on that ball there.
Oh, nice play right
Goes
there.
Goes out with the ball and a shot wide.
Very nice shot.
Don Connolly close to the ball. Regain possession for the Hudson Valley team. Connolly to Hoynes.
Hoynes looks like he's gonna, going
Hoynes
back to
Adele. Adele feed to Conn. He was already by the pipe, didn't take the shot. Good play.
Flag is down. Penalty situation.
31 blue for the USA team.
21.
Michael Iorio.
Good job on that name, Frank.
Michael Iorio serving a minute for a slash. Connelly with the shot.
Oh, nice shot by Donnie. Nice bounce shot through the legs.
Right through the legs of Joe Kismar from Wilton, Connecticut there. Pop. Didn't leave him much room, and he found the hole.
Donnie's outstanding shot.
So the Hudson Valley goes up. 12-9.
Three-goal lead. 12-9. Penalty is over. Face-off is about to start.
This is the second time the Hudson Valley team has enjoyed a three-goal lead. USA battled back to even go ahead. Let's see if they can do it again.
Let's see who we have on the face-off here. Kevin O'Connor for Hudson Valley. Joey Mahoney picks up the ball. Nice job by Joey.
Sold by Greg Trainer. Greg Trainer with the ball. Coming in for the USA team. He's open. He's going to have a shot.
Ball bounced up and right back in his pocket.
To feed DeMar. Behind the back. That ball's going to stay in bounds. He's going to have to play it.
Andy Seale.
Out to Andy Seale.
Beautiful play.
Great desperation check there by Ryan Wade.
Right on the goal, four-goal lead. Hudson Valley All-Stars, they are starting to take command of this game.
They sure are, Bob, and it's all starting with the ground ball. It's picking them up, getting possession of the ball, and we're going to have a timeout here by the USA team. We'll be right back after these few messages.
Americans throw away 25 billion polystyrene cups.
$1 out of every $10 we spend on food pays for packaging.
Less than 1% of the plastic we use is recycled.
Every year, we throw out enough office and writing paper to build a wall 12 feet high stretching from Los Angeles to New York City.
Buy stuff that's recycled. Recycle the stuff you buy. Take it back.
We're back with more fourth quarter action with the Hudson Valley team leading 13-9. Four-goal lead for the Hudson Valley squad.
Game like lacrosse, though, four goals is not a very large deficit, and Team USA could come back very quickly. So we're still going to have Hudson Valley team is going to have to put on a great effort to keep this lead. Face-off. Nice play by Cannon. Ball still on the ground.
Possession by
Ryan Wade. Stolen by the Hudson Valley team. Number 10, Paul Kahn. Cannon.
Hudson Valley playing smart here, not rushing the passes into the crease. Keeping the ball on the perimeter. Using up a little bit of clock.
Andrew Greenberg with the ball. Back to Bill Adell.
Over to Cannon. Cannon's got the ball now. Cannon looking for a shot. He's inside. Nice check. Ricky Beardsley with a behind-the-back beautiful pass. Ricky known for being flamboyant. At one point scored 5 goals in 5 games for Syracuse.
Greg Trainer with the shot. Bounced over. Yeah, Greg Trainer's not happy with that shot.
Looks like Ryan, we know Ryan's going to look for his shot. Ryan's coming in. Here it is. Cavett making a great save. Over to Sigelski, over his head a little bit, but Sigelski's on the ball. There we go. Have a penalty.
I thought the fatigue's starting to show, Bob.
Absolutely, it is,
Frank. Guys are diving, taking lazy checks. Really tough out there with that heat. And a timeout call by the Hudson Valley squad.
Timeout called by Coach Jim Turnbull. I'm sure that he's going to tell his troops to settle the ball down, use up a little clock. It's a hot day. They're in control right now. Cavett just made a beautiful save, beautiful outlet pass that caused the penalty. So right now,
they're just frustrating the USA offense there, Bob. Hudson Valley's going to be starting off with a man-up opportunity and a four-goal lead as they lead 13-9. Number 43, Ryan Wade, serving a minute slashing penalty.
Hudson Valley just getting the ball around the perimeter. Oh,
ooh, and he threw it away, and it's going to roll out of bounds. Possession's going to go to the USA team.
USA's goalie, Joey Kersmer's got the ball behind the cage. Usman Green chasing him.
Roy Colsey on with the ball. Ground ball picked up by the USA team, and the flag is down. There's going to be an upcoming slash on the Hudson Valley squad.
Oh, a beautiful play.
And a great save by Steve Cavett.
Even better save. Steve Cavett starting to take control out there.
And Jerry Kernan's going to have to serve a minute for a slash. I'm sorry. Al Malone's going to have to serve a minute for a slash.
Kristen Johns.
USA is going to have an opportunity to cut this deficit to three. Pass to Colsey. To Wade.
Wade.
Shot wide. Kristen Johns. Feed again to Colsey.
Quick pass.
Down to Marr.
Ball thrown away. Ricky Beardsley after the ball. Picks it up nicely. Redirects it across the field, but it looks like it's probably going to go out of bounds. Oh, nice play. Nice play, but couldn't quite keep it from going out. Eugene Curran. Very nice play. There goes Kevin O'Connor. Kevin gets hit in the face, but no call. Oh, yes, there was a call. Flag is down. I'm sure it's going to be a slashing call. No, I was wrong.
Kristen Johns was going for that ground ball. He got a little over anxious. That foot stepped down the line. That constitutes an offsides infraction. He's going to have to serve 30 seconds. So Hudson Valley will be a man up for 30 seconds.
Joey Borges is coming on in, looking for a shot.
Who's mine?
Here goes Joey.
Shot. Score.
Beautiful.
And that's 14-9 for the Hudson Valley team. Really putting on a late surge here. Really taking the play to the USA squad.
Penalty to Kristen Johns is over now. Paul Cannon out to take the faceoff for Hudson Valley team. Michael Hoynes and Joey Mahoney on the wings. Number 24 for Team USA, it's Dave Signor. From West Genesee High and going right now to Herkimer Community College will take the faceoff against Cannon. Faceoff won by Team USA. Lost possession, ball still on the ground. Billy Adele still after the ball. Very nice pickup by Bill Adele.
Nice ground ball by Bill. Don Connolly with the ball. Good check by the defender. But Connolly again retrieves the ground ball.
Donnie's having a great game. Donnie's one of those veteran players that you want on the field right at this time.
Oh, loose pass.
As I say that, Donnie has one of the few errors that he's had today and threw the ball out of bounds. That's all right, Donnie be back. Uh-oh, fast break opportunity for Team USA coming down the field straight down. Cavo forces the shot wide, though.
USA just squandering too many opportunities here late, Bob.
Absolutely.
They're going to have to start putting those away if they want to get back in this game.
Got to get a shot like that on cage. Make Cavo make a save.
Hudson Valley with a five-goal lead here. And a defense that's just frustrating the USA team.
Dave Moore with a roll move. Oh, what a play by Cavovit.
Great steal by Steve Cavovit. Andy Seale doubled, and Steve Cavett stepped out to take away the outlet pass.
Oh, but here we go.
There's no goalie. The goalie's out.
Steve's way out.
On the check. There's an open cage. Jacobs has the
Kevin
ball.
Kevin Jacobs, what defense, though?
The feed? Ooh, and the shot's wide. And the Hudson Valley's going to have possession of that ball. Bob, they're the closest to it when it went out.
And 40 left in the fourth quarter, and Al Blau has just called an official's timeout.
back here because Kavovic's on a hot streak. Hudson Valley is playing good perimeter 6-on-6 offense, keeping the ball out of the hands of Team USA.
The energy saved by recycling just one aluminum can could operate a television set for 3 hours.
For every 4 feet of newspaper you recycle, one tree is saved.
The energy saved by recycling just one glass bottle could light a 100-watt bulb for 4 hours.
It's good to recycle because the world can get trashed up and we don't want that to happen in our world.
Buy stuff that's recycled. Recycle the stuff you buy. Take it back.
To clear. Steve Cavett with the ball.
Over to Adam Silva of West Point.
Hudson Valley's just going to take its time here, try and clear the ball. They're up by 5. There really is no rush.
There goes Cavo. Cross, 80-yard pass right on the money. Beautiful play.
Think they set that up at that time out there, Bob?
I would have to think so. Coaching like Frank Vitola and Jim Turnbull, I would think that that was set up.
Ball behind with Adele.
Oh, Borges. Joey Borges.
Oh.
Oh. Right in the top 2 inches.
Joey Borges threading the needle from about 20 yards out.
6-goal lead now for Hudson Valley All-Stars, which makes the score
15-9.
15-9. It's been quite some time since Team USA scored a goal.
Yeah, Steve Cavett has really closed the door on him.
Absolutely. That's the difference right now, is the goal play of both Cross and in the third quarter and Cavett in the fourth quarter.
And the opportunities that the U.S. does get seem to be going by the wayside, Bob. Shots are going wide, high, everywhere but on or in the cage.
Well, USA is going to have a couple weeks to regroup, and I'm sure that there are players that are on the field that they're still trying to find positions for, and you know, when the games actually start in 2 weeks, it'll probably be a different story.
We're going to have to cut down those mistakes like Danny Sheehan just throwing the ball away there. Have to concentrate.
Ball on the ground. Bill Adele, another ground ball by Billy. Ball behind him. Picks it up again. There we go.
Again, the teams are playing international rules, which are 25-minute running quarters. So they're going to have to be a lot of endurance.
Gary
today and also in the tournament
the middle.
In 3 weeks.
Donnie Conley after the ball. Goes to the outside. Ricky Beardsley's got it. Here we go. We got another
number
penalty.
3, Don Conley's got to serve a minute for a slash. And USA has a chance here to get back on the board. Try and get themselves in this game.
I'm sure they're going to try and score quickly on this. Don't want to waste any time.
So they go right to Ryan Wade.
Roy Colsey going across the field to set up.
You know, Wade, Jacobs, Colsey up top.
Probably look for an outside shot from either Wade
Trainer
or Colsey.
To Colsey.
Inside.
Inside to DiMarzo as he sends it wide. Cavett with the ball.
Cavett, obviously the goalie was closest to it. Cavo taking his time. Running the ball around.
A little cat and mouse there. Getting a little trouble.
Steve's going straight up the field. Gets hit. Ball's on the ground. Cavo's out of the goal. Oh, Adam Silva with a crushing
check
to save a goal.
And Greg Traynor behind the back with no goal. He sends it in, put the U.S. on the board.
What a sequence of plays there with Cabo USA. Going up the field, the ball coming back down. A crushing blow by Adam Silva, and Traynor still puts the ball in behind his back. Great sequence.
That's the U.S. player. The whole cage is shoot at, and Silva just stepped up and closed that door, Bob. They had to make another pass.
Crushed him, Frank.
But Greg Traynor putting the ball away, and the U.S. is down by 5. Hudson Valley leads 15-10.
Face off Kevin O'Connor, doing what he does best, out there facing off for Hudson Valley.
Pulls it out and gets the ball.
We're going to have a penalty there.
They gave possession to Kevin. Procedure call, and Hudson Valley gains possession again. Bill Liddell, Rick Beardsley defending.
Bill Liddell and Kevin O'Connor, both of the University of Massachusetts.
Loose ball, picked off by the USA team. Upfield to Beardsley. Beardsley's going to take it across.
Looks like they may be offsides, though. Yes, that's true. They're offsides. Team USA was offsides on the play.
Yeah, Beardsley trying to get something started for the U.S., trying to take it over.
Somebody's got to stay back.
Take a shot with that long stick, but no one's staying back for him. Another miscue for the USA.
And again, it could, you have a hot day and people are getting tired, and that's when your mistakes like that happen. Andy Seal has the ball at midfield, over to Usman Green. Usman has it taken away. Oh. Anthony D'Andrea coming off the field.
Greg Traynor with the ball now as USA gains possession.
Ryan
Wade on. Usman Green defending.
Usman's playing good defense on him. Forced him to turn around, forced him to stop his flow. Very nice defense by Usman Green.
A great trainer with the ball. Short stick defending.
Oh, he's got the move, got the step, looking for a shot. Nice save by Cabo.
So we got down on that ball, Bob. Beautiful play by Cavett.
Yep.
Hudson Valley clears. And calls timeout.
Jim Turnbull calling the timeout. I'm sure to tell his troops to settle the ball down now and keep it around the perimeter.
And the score 15-10, Bob. 15-10. USA not capitalizing on their chances. And Hudson Valley, on the other hand, putting everything to get away.
Good team defense being played by the Hudson Valley team as well. I mean, everybody's hustling out there. It's good, excellent team play. Even though most of these players don't play on the same team, they all play in the same league. They're all familiar with each other, and it's showing right now. Jim's giving his players a chance to get a break here, get a drink of water. I'm sure there's about 5 minutes left to go in the game.
And again, today's game is brought to you by the Hudson Valley Lacrosse Foundation, the chapter of the Lacrosse Foundation here at Hudson Valley. And Continental Cable Vision.
And Community Channel number 6. And we thank them very much.
Thank one and all.
Yeah, we thank them for coming and
we thank you today for watching.
We're thanking everybody, aren't we, Frank?
That's right, Bob.
Okay, we're getting ready to start the action again.
Hudson Valley will have possession.
I think it'll be Michael Hoynes up at the top.
It's a hot day down there, Bob.
It is.
Got a little breeze blowing in here now this afternoon. I'm sure all them players are enjoying that.
Michael Hoynes and John Kniff, members of the armed forces, the United States Army during Desert Storm, and we're over in the desert during the activities over there.
Yeah, John Kniff with the ball now.
Over to Hoynes, a little bit over his head. Here we go. Now, this is when Hudson Valley's got to be careful.
Yeah, those two give a new meaning to the phrase cagey veterans.
Absolutely. There he goes. There goes Hoynes taking the ball away. Very nice play. Nugent has the ball, bringing it in. You have to believe at this time that Team USA is going to start looking for shots from the outside.
Gotta start looking from shots somewhere, Bob.
There goes a penalty right
there.
You're
gonna have a man up opportunity right
now.
Sure,
you'll have Colsey back on the field now, and again, it's gonna be Ryan Wade and Roy Colsey looking for their blasts.
And Paul Cannon picking up his third or fourth penalty of the day here. We'll serve 30 more seconds for all.
Paul getting used to that seat right next. Paul's getting used to that seat next to the scorer's table.
I think he took that penalty just to sit down.
Paul's played a great game though. Kavovit, nice play, throwing the ball down the field.
That's going to count as a shot on net there, Bob.
Shot on goal by Steve Kavovit. Oh, here goes Kniff with a steal, coming in, gets the ball.
Donnie Connolly.
Oh, fantastic!
Great save.
Great save.
Great save by
Joel
Kersmer.
Back to Connolly. Connolly's going again.
Another great save.
I said it first. Penalty is over. Goalie's got the ball. Interference right there. Ball go back to Hudson Valley.
Joe Kersmer's holding on for dear life there in that goal there, Bob.
Great saves.
Doing everything he can to keep that USA team in this game.
Donnie Connolly knows how to thread the needle, and those are great shots. He just came up with better saves.
Paul Cannon out of the box. And
in the game.
In the game.
Oh, the whistle.
Moving pick called on the green. Blue has the ball.
And here we go again.
USA brings it up the field.
Nugent to Ryan.
To Wade.
Over.
Tamar. Score.
No, it was Chris and Johns.
Chris and Johns.
Good job by Chris.
Kristen Johns cuts the lead to 4. The score is now 15, Hudson Valley. USA 11.
15-11. Petey. Gonna find out how much time is left in the game right now. We have a 4-goal lead. Minute and a half left in the game. Possession by Hudson Valley. Joey Borges has the ball now. Back over to Kevin O'Connor. Back to Borges. Ball on the ground. Borges picks it up again behind the back to Connolly. Oh, what a shot by Donnie Connolly. 45 seconds left to go in the contest. John Kniff with the ball. Ball down on the ground. Nice check by Beardsley. Beautiful job of wasting time right now. Team USA double teaming, but Donnie Connolly running through the crease. Here we go. 5 seconds to go. 5. I'm sorry. 5 seconds now. Here it is. Steve Kavovit just throws the ball up, and that should do it.
And that'll do it for us here today.
And that wraps up our game. Final score is the Hudson Valley All-Stars 15, the Team USA 11. Fantastic day, fantastic game, and we'll be back after... We'll be back to wrap things up after this. Thank you very much.
Lyme disease is transmitted by a tick the size of a pinhead, which can attack during a walk in the woods or a park or even in your own backyard. But tick bites can be prevented, and the disease can often be successfully treated, especially in the early stages. The Will Rogers Institute is offering a free booklet to help you learn about Lyme disease. It tells how to recognize the symptoms and the best ways to reduce your chances of getting it. For your free copy, write the Will Rogers Institute, White Plains, New York.
This is Bob Wheatley back to wrap this up. The Hudson Valley All-Stars have defeated the Team USA 19 and under junior nationals by a score of 15-11. With me are Hudson Valley goalies Stephen Kavovit and Michael Cross. Guys, fantastic game. What'd you think, Michael?
Well, it was a really tough game. I haven't seen Neville Lake dance since I graduated from Cornell in 91, and I was really hot out there. I was dying.
Stephen, how'd your defense play?
I thought they played well. Those guys are a little too quick, you know, young, and they got the legs with them, and they just outran us. But our defense hung in there pretty well, and they played some good, strong defense.
You think the team got tired at all? I mean, with the heat and the fact that you haven't been together, did Coach Turnbull or Coach Vitola tell you guys to keep it around the perimeter at the end of the game?
Well, definitely we were getting tired. Even in the first quarter, we were getting tired. But we slowed it down a little. And near the end of the game, you could see a lot of people just taking it easy and pacing themselves. But it was really tough, though, with the heat.
Steven, what do you think about some of those shots that you were getting on you today?
They're definitely a real good shooting team. They picked their spots, and they move the ball real well. They're definitely going to be a good team and good standings against the foreign teams that are coming in.
Guys, thanks very much. Good luck the rest of the summer. This is Bob Wheatley for Continental Cable Vision, Channel 6, wrapping it up again. The game was sponsored by the Hudson Valley Chapter of the Lacrosse Association. We appreciate your time, and thank you very much for watching. Goodbye now.
Hello, I'm George Delaney, Vice President of Con Edison's Westchester Division. During 1991, Con Edison has developed a new approach to help our customers use their energy more efficiently. This approach, called Enlightened Energy, doesn't ask people to do